Good afternoon. My name is Ava, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to our liturgy today. We extend a warm welcome to anyone who might be visiting with us or to those who are new to our parish. In the spirit of Christian fellowship, please turn to those near you, maybe to someone you do not know or someone alone, and extend a warm welcome. Today is the 15th Sunday of Ordinary Time. Today's readings remind us of our divine adoption as God's children and of our call to preach the good news of Jesus by bearing witness to God's love, mercy, and salvation as revealed through Jesus. God chose us in Christ before the foundation of the world. The celebrant for our liturgy is Father Chux. This Mass is being offered for Carrie Ann Hogan, Father Ed Keeley, Father Stan Swamy, Jim Nolan, Rajesh Rodriguez, Christopher Kama, and Kathy Bright.
Good afternoon, everyone. Please stand and join our moment again. All are welcome.
Thank you. so that they may return to the right path. Give all for the faith they profess and accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Amaziah, priest of Bethel, said to Amos, "Off with you, visionary, flee to the land of Judah. There earn your bread by prophesying, but never again prophesy in Bethel, for it is the king's sanctuary and royal temple." Amos answered Amaziah, "I was no prophet, nor did I belong to a company of prophets. I was a shepherd and a dresser of sycamores. The Lord took me from following the flock and said to me, 'Go prophesy to my people Israel.'" The word of the Lord. Might exist for the praise of his glory, we who first hoped in Christ. In him, you also, who have heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and have believed in him, were sealed with the promised Holy Spirit, which is the first installment of our inheritance for redemption as God's possession, to the praise of his glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Security, and of course, they get asked to go back.
I know with the exception of senior citizens who get private, you know, in body, but, you know, other people go through difficulties when they are boarding an aircraft. So today, hearing Jesus talking of the 12 not taking a lot of stuff with them, just to make things easy and simple for them in terms of being able to relay the message he wants them to deliver to the people. Heal the sick, anoint them with oil, grant them forgiveness. That's all he wanted. And he knew if they take a lot of stuff with them, it's going to put them back and distract them from their mission. And we as Christians today, we have been sent because we've been anointed, we've been called to preach, to deliver, to heal, to strengthen and to comfort, not only ourselves, but family members and friends. We're talking of material things that could pull us back, but there are also things that are immaterial that could pull us back from fulfilling the mission that God calls us to. Things like anger, you know, anger that we carry most often that hinder us from reaching out to people. Also, there are other things, you know, that could hinder us from being able to make calls even to family members or friends. Those are the things that could become a distraction and not help us to fulfill the mission that Christ calls us to. So it's a big challenge, especially for us in our society today, where, you know, with what is going on around us in our country, in our neighborhoods, there are really a lot of divisions, a lot of anger, and a lot of frustration. And the gospel tells us, as Mark tells us in the gospel today, leave those aside and pay attention to the mission that Christ has given to us. It's a big challenge in our society today. And the question is, am I ready? Are you ready to take up that responsibility? To leave behind things that pull us back, to be able to reach out to others, touch them, give them healing. Because that healing is not from us. It's God that does the healing through each and every one of us. So we pray that we will not hinder God's transmission of healing and strength and comfort, especially in our society that is wounded today. But let that spirit and let the power of God walk through us and touch the life of others, so that there we have hope, there and we will be healed and strengthened. May we rise and profess our faith. We pray the Apostles' Creed, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, Father Almighty.
Gospel message. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God for raising our spirits through the gift of sport, and in particularly, we pray for the players who bring joy and excitement to so many at this difficult time. We pray to the Lord. For those suffering from extreme heat, droughts, floods, and forest fires, for an end to violence throughout the world, and for all whose lives are endangered in the pursuit of peace. We pray to the Lord. For those who are homeless during the summer, that they may, in this year of St. Joseph, find worthy and safe accommodation. We pray to the Lord. For the spiritual and physical well-being and renewal of all parishioners, especially Baby Josie Gray, Grace Rosie, Angela Barusso, Caroline Worth, Nicholas Hurley, Geraldine Frailer, and for those celebrating wedding anniversaries this month, and for those who have died recently, including Father Ed Keeley, Father Stan Swamley, Christopher Kama, Gloria Ward, Marianne Pollock, James Nolan Jr., and those who have died in the Miami tragedy, and for all who are mourning, we pray to the Lord. For the special intentions of all gathered here and the unspoken prayers in our hearts. And this Mass being offered for Carrie Ann Logan, Father Ed Keeley, Father Stan Swamy, Jim Nolan, Rajesh Rodriguez, Christopher Kama, and Kathleen Wright. We pray to the Lord.
Let us pray. Dear St. Joseph, guardian of the Redeemer, spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to you God entrusted his only Son, in you Mary placed her trust. With you Christ became man. Blessed St. Joseph, to us too, show yourself a Father, guide us in the path of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy, and courage, and defend us from every evil. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please join our offertory hymn with One Bread, One Body.
Sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his holy church.
grand awakening consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord will be with you. Lift up your
hearts.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just that we tell our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, mighty and eternal God, for you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sin we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks. As in exaltation, we are glad.
Throughout the ages. May merit to be co-heirs to eternal
eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
From Montauk Lighthouse to the Alzheimer's Center in Westbury. James was seeing a fundraising on July 26th at Morrison's in Plainview. Enjoy a great meal, have fun, and support James around. The monthly food drive runs up Columbus schedule for the next weekend. The same party and parish picnic was to run at Columbus Colloquias Youth Group on Sunday, July 18th from noon to 5 p.m. at the community park, Plainview. Feast of St. Patrick will be celebrated on Sunday, August 22nd at 12 p.m. Mass. Our main celebration will be Father Frank Pizzarelli. After Mass, we will have hospitality in the chain, all are welcome. St. Patrick Parish Gala will be celebrated Sunday, October 17th from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. at Chris Hollow Country Club with Mary. As I said last week, be careful about the scams via emails and text messages, so please don't entertain any of these emails and messages. They are just after your money, so be careful. As we all know, the fund raised in the annual Catholic appeal are important not only to support the work of the Catholic Church in essence of the counties, but also because more those funds directly support the St. Patrick in a form of rebate money received from parishioners' contribution. Till last Friday, 115 families have pledged $36,647. Our goal this year is $14,400. Please help us to achieve our goal at the end of this month, July 2021. Additionally, I wish to say thank you to all who have already donated and made pledges to the appeal. Your support and generosity are greatly appreciated and are a sign of your commitment to your faith and your love for St. Pius X. As your pastor, I'm personally very, very grateful for your goodness. A special word of thanks to Mrs. Claire Crossley for a long hour personal calls to parishioners, reminding them about Catholic appeal. So thank you, Claire. And a joke. Somebody wants to hear my joke, all right? Four women were sitting discussing their sons. The first proudly stated that her son was a bishop. So when he enters the room, people addressing Your Excellency. The second, not to be outdone, said that her son is an archbishop. So when he enters the room, people address him as Your Grace. The third party said that her son was a cardinal. So when he enters the room, the people say, Your Eminence. The fourth one said, well, my son is 7 feet and 2 inches tall and weighs 430 pounds. When he walks into the room, people say, my God. Please stand for the congratulations.
Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, his certain effects upon us may grow. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth in peace. This Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
You all have a great evening.
Thank you, God.
Please join our closing hymn, take and eat.